you do that. But Dwyer will only tell you the same thing. The security, he is slack enough as it is without mixing that bunch together.
Then I'll assure him you and Miss Ferguson will be in charge of security. That should eliminate any objections.
I don't need anyone's sympathy, least of all yours.
Yeah. Right.
Hang on. One thing before you go. I know I've changed. I had to cope with Blackmore. Those women find out that I'm some middle-class achiever, they'll blacklist me out of spite. Just don't blow it for me, okay?
Okay.
Rich, Rich, what is it? You're less or something. Come here!
You'll be on a charge the minute I get back. What's your name?
Getting out of the bitch wanted as much as me.
I said, what's your name?
Stud, you want to hear why?
You're on the charge.
Don't mind him, love. He's just having a bit of fun.
Hell on my
phone. Don't you touch us, you will stop it!
Well, he is.
Get on your mill.
Now, you stay out of my way.
You're a git!
Take it easy, Lisa. Come on.
We had someone like you in charge, these sort of things wouldn't crop up.
You don't do such a bad job yourself. I've noticed the way you work on the women. It's good stuff.
Thank you.
You know, with you running this place and me at Blackmore, we'd soon get things straightened out.
Aren't we all forgetting something? Now, one of those guys could have raped Lisa had Mrs. Pringle not got there in time. So now's our opportunity to get back at them.
So? We give them what for? Then we grab one each.
Sorry.
You're not going to be able to do anything anyway. The place will be crawling with screws.
Oh, yes, we will. And I know just how to get them back. What do you say, girls?
Yeah. Oh, come on. Tell us what you're going to do first.
Run me and spike kidney. I'll fill you in later.
Not such a wind place after all.
Looks like real fireworks coming up.
Reynolds won't be easy to shift.
I've done it before.
Yeah, I heard about the last time you took over. Hardly warmed the seat before she was back in it.
She was just lucky that time. I couldn't help it if the circumstances
were... Okay, nobody's saying it was your fault. It's just that when we tip her out this time, we want to make sure she stays out.
Well, her first mistake will be allowing the men and women to mix during recreation. I think that could do the job.
Could make sure it does.
Thought you might.
Yes, leave it to me. You'll get your governorship, but I want the credit.
I'm only too willing to help.
I'll let you know when you need it. In the meantime, leave the details to me.
Anything I can help with?
No. It just appears that a couple of my officers are having a little trouble settling in. I said I'd help out by speaking to them.
I see.
Oh, look, if there's a problem, if you think I'm infringing on...
No, not at all. Coffee, Meg?
Please.
Those two are getting chummier than ever.
Probably cooking up something to make our jobs harder.
I think Craven's determined to have a go at everyone. It's not just Marty.
Look, if you want to pursue that charge of sexual harassment against him, just let me know.
There's not much point without a witness, thanks all the same.
Yes, he certainly knows how to protect his back.
But surely he's gone too far this time. I mean, he actually ordered that officer to shoot Bongo.
I wouldn't get my hopes up, Meg. The department's investigators have to prove he had no justification. And knowing how cagey Craven is, that's not going to be easy.
Pair of juices. Well, come on, what do you got?
Hey?
Juices, can you beat them or not?
Yeah, three jacks. About the only time I get a bloke these days, playing cards.
Thought that's where your mind must have been. It sure isn't on the game.
Yeah, well, I don't want to play anymore. I can't get me mind off what's in the other block.
Yeah, well, you're going to have to put it on hold for a minute. Don't forget we're bringing those bludgers down a peg as soon as we get a chance.
Oh, don't remind me. Probably bugger up my chances of ever getting laid.
Alice, can I borrow you for a minute?
What?
I need your advice. I'm doing this questionnaire on your perfect mate. Do you think brown eyes are sexy or blue? I've never been able to make up my mind.
I'd take either. Just so long as they look at you real passionate.
Oh, Bubby, any news on lunch? We're all starving.
Yeah.
What gives?
What do you expect? Some mad screw roped the blokes into cooking the food.
You're kidding.
And it's you and me that have to dish it up. We're on serving duty.
Hey, I'll take over if you like.
No. Alice, you'd never be able to change, not after Mrs. Pringle catching you before. Cheer up, you're bound to get a chance sooner or later.
Bugger that. I'm going to introduce myself right now.
Alice, don't you
dare. Alice, it's all over the place.
Excuse me, Mr. Blunt. I can't quite read these instructions here. It's printed too small.
I would have thought the frozen peas are the one thing that you could cook.
Yeah, well, I never cooked for so many before, have I?
Take a large saucepan of boiling water. Add salt and empty contents into saucepan. I think you can manage that?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Jenkins. I've just come in for the food tray for the pound. Mrs. Morris wanted to know if it was ready.
Hang around and wait for it if you like. Shouldn't be too long.
Yeah, sure.
Now come off it, Wilson. You know the rules.
I also know how much you enjoy a cuppa, Rick. Why don't you go off and have one? Come back when everything's fixed up.
Boy, you got them eating out of your hands.
Blackmore screws find out which side their bread's buttered on pretty quick. So, what do they call you? Now, let me guess. Shorty.
Nah, just Alice.
Yeah? Prime real estate, eh, Billy?
Yeah, lots of blokes that get their eye teeth for a go with you, darling.
Yeah? Hey, what's your names?
Well, this is Billy. I'm Stud.
Wow. Bet you're real good with a name like that, eh?
Oh, so they reckon. Got a mate who's even better, though.
Oh, you mean Billy?
Nah. A fella called Archie Trimble.
Oh, one of yous do.
No, not me, love. I've got a wife and two kids.
Nah, look, Archie's a living legend. I mean, you've heard of Trimble the Nimble, haven't you?
No, sounds like something to do the sewing with.
No, he's the best. He's left a trail of smiling women longer than the Murray River.
Loves tall Sheilas. Reckons they're real sexy. Yeah. What do you say?
Oh, girl, it'd be stupid if she didn't say yes.
Wait here. In case there's a screw comes along, Bill will go and fetch Archie for you.
Don't you go away.
No.
Oh. Here's a little something to munch on while you wait.
Oh, thanks,
man. Someone's told you about the special buy-up for the men?
They arrived with nothing. It's obvious they've been eating the basics. A few of the other supplies wouldn't go astray either.
Oh?
We've just landed ourselves a whole new clientele. It'd be ashamed to waste it.
You just said they arrived with nothing.
Nothing but what they were wearing. It's easy to smuggle cash out in clothing, especially in the chaos of a fire.
If you've got any ideas of selling the men contraband, you can forget it now.
But this is the best break we've had in months.
I thought you had brains, Maxwell. The joint is crawling with new officers, and I will not risk the entire operation for the sake of short-term profits.
Whatever you say.
Exactly.
She's still in there?
Yeah, ready your
room. All set.
Oh, he's here. Come here. He's dying, ain't you?
Girl could have the passion froze out of her waiting in there.
She's not a bad one, lad.
Where's the hunk you promised?
Well, he's right in front of you. Archie Trimble, Mood Alice. How old are you again, Arch?
70, give or take a year. Don't feel older than 60, but.
You buggers! Oh!
And let me make one thing clear, Connors. You're being put back with the others solely on the proviso that you don't cause trouble, especially with the Blackmore officers. Look, I know what happened to you at Blackmore was painful.
What's happening to the bastard who killed me, brother? He's getting off scot-bloody free. How do you reckon I feel about that?
It's up to the investigators to decide if anyone's to blame. If you take the law into your own hands, I'll have you back in solitary. Is that understood? I'm warning you. I'm quite prepared to have you put back now if you won't give me a guarantee
right.
That you won't cause trouble.
So I'll keep my nose clean. You finished?
No, I haven't. I'm quite sure you're aware that Kath Maxwell's now top dog. I want you to cooperate with her in settling the women down after all the disruptions. I know there was friction between you before, but Maxwell's one of the ones who spoke loudest against your transfer to Blackmore.
Well, that makes us bosom buddies, I suppose.
Maxwell's prepared to forget past hostilities for the good of the women. I suggest you do the same. Right, you can go. But remember, one more step out of line and I'll throw the book at you.
Rotten buggers. What's wrong with trying to make the place less of a hole? Made me feel like a bit of dirt.
Yeah.
Thanks.
The one thing I can't understand about some men,
And some of them can be so callous. It's as if they enjoy humiliating us just to bolster their silly little egos. The one thing is that you had the courage to throw it back in their faces and walk straight out.
Geez, you're a good mate, Laurie. Hope everything works out for you all right tomorrow. You sure deserve it.
Yeah, what's it to work out? I'm pleading guilty. Guess I'm just going to have to wait for my sentence.
Hey, maybe if you do one of your fast-talking jobs on him.
Reed!
Geez, Reed!
Are you all right?
Fine, considering my kid brother's dead and his killer's running free.
Oh, look, it was just dreadful what happened to you. Just we were so upset.
Is there going to be an investigation or nothing? Not for the bloke who done it?
Well, you know what they say. We all know how that's going to end up. Anyway, what's new? They tell me Kath Maxwell's top dog.
Wasn't because I let her or nothing. I did me best, honest.
Dump hasn't changed much.
Would you like a cup of tea? I mean, the kettle's boiled.
No, thanks.
We hear you done a good job at Blackmore. The papers were full of it. It was on telly and everything.
Yeah, well, it did a pretty good job on me, too.
You must be glad to be back here. My whole report's that place sounds like a dirty, evil dungeon.
Look, there's nothing to stop us going after Maxwell, is there? You know, like the old days. You, me, Laurie, the last of the Wentworth warriors.
Look, if you want to go after Maxwell, you'll have to do it yourself. The only bastard I am wants craving.
How did you hear what they pulled on Jenkins? What a hoot!
Yeah, great.
Oh, I wish I'd seen the look on her face. Archie Trimble's about 90, not out. What's the matter with you? Planning your own little soiree, are you? With Spunko Jackson.
Nick off, Brandy, again.
Let's chatter, please.
Mrs. Morris. I hope the meals aren't going to be this late all the time. The women aren't too happy about it.
Oh. Well, if we'd known that Blackmore was going to be burnt down, we might have been better prepared.
Yes, well, that's your problem, isn't it? My responsibility is to the women.
Rita, good to see you. Okay, everyone, three cheers for Rita the Conqueror Connors. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Everyone,
hip hip! Hooray!
Two meals!
I mean it. We're glad you're back. Well, it looks like you got the dump finally sewn up.
I'm top dog, if that's what you mean. All above board.
Look, things are running pretty smoothly at the moment. I'm sure we can let bygones be bygones.
How's it going, Meagher? Heard about you having a go at Craven. Good one.
There's a place on my table if you're interested. I hope you're not going to be ungrateful for what we did trying to help you.
That's how she got most of the shields on side. Double talk about owing her favours and stuff.
Listen, if I told you, I'm not interested.
But she's setting you up now. We've got to stop her before she walks all over.
You're so worried about her, you stop her. I've got better things to think about.
Jenkins, if you're not hungry, go back to the rec room.
Jeez, Reed, I know how you feel about that.
You don't know how I feel.
Never mind, I've got some catching up to do with some of me mates.
Your bib handy? We've got some footies coming in, courtesy of me old man.
Hey?
Yeah, my dad rang today. He's over the moon, I got out all right. And he's sending me some stuff, and one of my cousins is sending all her old mills and booms.
Yeah?
Boy, you know, being in here ain't like being in the clink at all.
Yeah, except for the bars.
What's the matter with you? You've been acting weird all day.
There's nothing wrong with me.
Oh, pigs. It's because your folks haven't rung yet, right?
It's not because of anything. And do us both a favour and stop playing amateur psychiatrist.
Why not? I'm pretty good at it, aren't I? Oh, look, so don't worry. They're probably trying to find out right now if their darling little Margaret's all right.
And as far as they're concerned, their darling Margaret died the minute she met the hippie professor. And that's the way I wanted to stay.
Jeez, we're really biting the lemon today, aren't we?
Yeah, well, I got reason to.
Do you want to talk about it?
Nah.
Suit yourself. Just don't go getting all gloomy on me. You'll spoil me holiday.
On your feet, Connors.
If you've come to tuck me in, I can do it myself.
You know what I dislike about you, Connors? Everything from your smart-aleck mouth to your pig-pen feet. Doesn't this belong in the rec room, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, it does, Mr. Craven. Prisoners are only allowed their own magazines in the dorms. You know that, Connors.
So give me another 12 months!
What's the matter, Connors? Still overreacting to your brother's death?
You bastard!
Go ahead. Give me an excuse to use it. Give us a moment, would you, Miss Ferguson? I think Connors and I have still got something to discuss.
By all means.
You big man with that wand in your hand.
It's up to you whether I use it or not.
Seems to me you're going to anyway.
That depends on you, Connors, on whether or not you give me the right answers. Don't make the mistake of underestimating me, Connors. Keep pushing for an investigation, and so help me, you'll live to regret it. Well, what's it to be? Low down scum. You're all the same. Won't come at me because you haven't got the guts.
Look, Hagen will be along in a minute.
That's just the start of it, Connors.
You're too right, because I'm going to get you, you bastard.
Not while your friends can be got at, you won't. That's right. Jenkins and her mates. You've just made them very vulnerable, Connors. I'm sure you're aware of just how difficult it was for me to give the order to shoot.
And of course, but you were in a very difficult position. There was no other alternative?
I'm the first to speak on Mr. Craven's behalf, sir. It was a last resort. The rioters simply would not listen to reason.
That's what I thought. Well, don't worry, Craven. What's happened won't affect your service record in any way at all. Unfortunate incident, but unavoidable.
So there'll be no need for a departmental inquiry, then?
Oh, we mustn't forget that I am accountable to the electorate. Justice must be seen to be done. That is, after all, the basis of our democratic system, is it not? It's a simple formality, I can promise you, the merest inconvenience.
But surely the taxpayers' money could be saved by avoiding a full-scale inquiry.
Gone too far, I'm afraid. I've just had a phone call from Mrs. Reynolds. Formal allegation has been laid by one of the prisoners, the sister of the deceased, I believe. You know how it is when the wheels are set in motion. However, on that other small matter of the junior officer, Martin Jackson, I think I may have some better news for you on that front.
Come along. Line up quietly.
Is that scam with the bloke still on for this morning?
I said it was, didn't I?
You'd be lucky. Security will be tight as a drum for that meeting.
So we make doubly sure we time every
meeting. I am warning you, keep this noise up and your afternoon meeting with the male prisoners is as good as cancelled. Oh, Wilkinson, come with me after muster and I'll get some clothes for your court appearance.
Thanks, Mrs. Morning.
Jeez, Maxwell never gives up. Even making Laurie's idea about the bloke sound like hers now.
Oh, look, give it a rest, will you, Lurch?
No, not this time. I thought you'd be enthusiastic after what happened yesterday.
Listen, something I've got to tell you about Craig.
Now get this line straightened up for the head count. And that includes you, Connors.
The fact is, you deliberately questioned the actions of the governor of Blackmore. Unacceptable under any circumstances.
With all respect, sir.
Exactly what I am getting at. Respect is something one earns, young man, and one doesn't earn it by undermining one's superiors. Do you understand what I am saying?
I understand that a governor's job is to prevent violence, not provoke it.
No? What makes you say that?
Well, if Mr. Craven hadn't acted so hastily, I might have talked those women into giving themselves up and prevented the prisoner from being shot.
You honestly expect me to believe that?
That's up to you, sir.
Correct. So I'm placing you on 3 months probation. One foot wrong and you're out for good. Think yourself lucky I'm giving you a chance to redeem yourself. If it wasn't for your mother, you wouldn't even be getting...
What's my mother got to do with this?
She's a fine officer. You'd do well to learn from her example.
Look, I'm not interested in any favouritism.
Mind your tongue, boy. I mightn't be so generous a second time. Now, I've made my decision. Let this be an end to it. Let Mrs. Reynolds know I am finished with her office.
How did it go?
3 months probation. The only reason I'm still on the payroll is because my mother happens to be a respected officer.
What? Who said that?
Dwyer. Who else?
I haven't spoken to Dwyer for months. Oh, Marty, the last thing I would do is go behind your back to someone like him.
I know.
Well, whilst you're here, you can help me with these super forms. I've done the A to M's, you can do the N to Z's.
Sure. Should have stayed in the Navy. An animal like Craven would have been drummed out in 5 seconds. He's a sadist. How the hell do you beat him?
By not giving him an inch and letting him know he can't intimidate you into making his job easier.
Dwyer's right, you're a good officer. And an even better man.
Yeah, it's a pity we didn't have more luck with Jackson. Oh, probation. They might just as well have given him a pat on the head and told him to try harder.
Probation's easily breached. And when you're in as governor...
Yeah, you're right. You know, when you come to think of it, the real strength lies here.
You're learning. I think it's about time we showed Connors just how real that strength can be. Those friends of hers, Jenkins and the dizzy one.
Wilkins.
We warned Connors what had happened to them if she didn't play the game. She's not playing the game, is she?
You've been on it all morning.
You've got to have a pilot's license to work this one. Bugger off.
Bugger yourself. It's my turn.
Off, you lot, or I'll take it off of you.
Oh, give us a break. We haven't seen one of these before.
A press?
In Blackmore, we had to press everything with flat irons.
Hey?
The contraption we had was nearly as ancient.
Oh. Geez, I reckon. This one's a beauty. Okay, if I keep going, Alice, we'll stop larking around.
Yeah, okay.
You will?
You heard the boss.
Hey, you finished with this lot yet?
Oh, for heaven's sake, what's the hurry? Sorry, Alice, I just wish I could get this court case over and done with.
Oh, no rush, is there? Longer you take to figure it out, the better.
What's there to figure out?
Are you still going to go for guilty?
I think my record will speak for itself whether I wanted to or not.
Oh, Reed, hey. Hi, Reed.
You got a minute?
Sure.
Listen, I didn't get a chance to tell you before about getting Craven.
Yeah, look, we understand. We know he got bombed.
I really wish you wouldn't
listen,
do this.
Listen, hang on.
He's threatening to get you guys if I don't drop the allegations.
Well, there's no need to worry about us.
We're not afraid of him. We can look after ourselves.
Yeah, sure. But that bastard's got to go, and I've got to move fast now. He's threatening to get you lot as well.
Oh, you reckon he'd really try? A bit hard getting away with it in here.
He's getting away with murder already, remember? So, I need some cash.
How much?
You're not even going to ask me why?
No. We know you'll put it to good use.
Thanks.
You worked out how to get him?
No. But I'm sure it's all going to be ready when the time comes. And, don't worry. We'll get Maxwell, too. As soon as I've finished with Craven.
Had a big day?
Can't complain.
I guess not. No one's up to giving you any reason to, are they?
Is this a social call, is it?
With you?
I'm looking for Spider. Have you seen her?
Oh, we don't move in the same circles anymore. Not unless I need her.
Yeah, I heard you were playing the Lone Ranger these days. With a little help from your mates from the other side.
You certainly taught me there was strength in numbers.
Well, you just watch what you're doing. Because you might find your number will be up sooner than you think.
I've got too much protection now, Connors. So why don't you wise up? We'd make a good team. Here. There's no reason why we can't both clean up.
No reason at all. There you are. You like cleaning up so much?
Now remember, Laurie, just keep it together and it'll be all right.
What if I get the same judge?
What's it matter? You're handing yourself to him on a plate.
Van's waiting, Wilkinson. Hurry it up.
Coming, Mr. Adams. The way you front the bastards can mean the difference between 5 and 10, okay?
Yeah, and that could make a big difference to your kid.
Yeah, you're right. Wish me luck.
Okay.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. Bye.
All the best.
Good luck, Laurie.
Look after yourself, you hear me?
Okay, quiet, everyone. Now, the time has come to make sure you all know what's going to happen when we meet the men this afternoon. Oh. Okay, keep it down. Now, when we get out there, someone will get Wilson out of sight behind the shop. That'll be your job, Lisa.
Come, Moffat. Why have I got to be the bunny?
Why do you think?
Yeah, couldn't see him going for Maxwell.
Oh, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I reckon he and Adams might have the same taste.
Now, you'll have backup, so just fend him off as best you can until they get there.
Well, they'd be damn quick.
They will be.
Now, the first group will distract the screws. We'll improvise that depending on the layout. And the second will make a break for the shop and grab this stud character. Right. You know we'll all go for a row.
Who cares? It'll be worth it.
I can't send you to Blackmore, Alice.
No. No, I owe that rotten mongrel too.
It's all there, handed over. I'll give you a discount if you promise it's for Maxwell.
Is this thing balanced?
It's what you paid for.
Start walking in wars and you'll apply for the rest of us.
Give us a break. It's like being in a bar in the Regent compared to the grap that we've got at Blackwell.
Yeah? Closest you ever got to the Regent was rolling drunks in the car park.
I suppose you're going to tell me you spent all your time in the bridal suite.
Correct.
Hello, boys.
Just saying, a stud. It's like a hotel here.
Yes, it's a pity it hasn't got an ensuite as well, isn't it, Slocum?
Yeah.
Because you want to go to the bog right now, isn't that right?
Yeah. Yeah. Reagan, you're right, Mr. Crane.
How are you feeling, stud?
Fine, just fine, Mr. Crow.
Well, that's good. That's good because I've got a little job for you.
Shoot.
Reynolds meeting. I want you to pay particular attention to one of those slags from Wentworth. You've seen around. Jenkins. A bit on the horsey side.
Yeah, I know the one. Well, what do I have to do?
We both know you've got two specialities, stud. Oh, come on, boy, don't be shy. I thought you'd jump at the chance of knocking a bit of sense into him.
What, you want to smoke the run out in the open?
You'll be covered.
Look, I know you've got your reasons, sir.
Yes, I have got my reasons, Wilson, and don't you forget it. I want her hurt. Because if she's not, you can forget about your other speciality for quite some time.
Keep them in line, okay?
Yes, indeed.
Look at the sheep.
Oi!
Look at them. Look at them. That's supposed to be a joke. But they're real pleased to see it.
Come on, you lot. I want you in a single line up here.
Here.
Now.
Just remember what you have to do.
Keep for yourself.
Looks like being quite a garden party.
We don't have to worry about uninvited guests.
Could I have your attention for a moment, please?
Quiet!
As you know, there have been different points of view on whether this meeting is in the best interest of the prison. It's our policy here to also consider what's in the best interest of the inmates.
Yeah, like the redhead.
Your moral interest as well, I think.
I hope she enjoys her moment.
And just how long is this moment going to last?
When the prattle's finished, Wilson will talk Jenkins into a meeting behind the shop.
Shouldn't have too much of a problem there.
No, my officers will close ranks as soon as our young lovers slip through.
Oh, do your officers always back you like that?
Let's just say we have a different manual at Blackmore.
You must send me a copy.
It's finished. Now you'll see how things are done properly.
This is just to pressure Connors, isn't it?
Of course. Well, come on, Wilson. Get on with it. It's almost romantic, isn't it?
They're a bunch of bloody jerks. Not yet, I'm not. I set this up and I'll see it through.
She's right. There's more screws in the bloody hardware store.
We've got to do something.
Oh, you're changing your tune, aren't you?
Oh, just look at them. You reckon we're on sale or something?
So? I'm on special myself.
Look at the bastard. You better be there.
Oh,
What's going on?
Doesn't look good. Spider, you and Alice get over there and start a fight. Quick.
Alice, over here.
Well, what is it?
Wants to see you.
Are you having me on?
Nope. It's all yours, thank God.
Me too.
Hey, same plan, remember?
Oh, bugger off. If I'm not back in a week, you can send out a search party.
Alice.
So hiya, hey?
Hi yourself.
I hope you didn't mind about the business with old Archer this morning.
It was a pretty dirty trick.
Knew you had a sense of humour, bud. So, what's a nice girl like you doing in a place like this, huh?
Looking for a good time. What do you reckon?
No, it's a good time just waiting to happen. Already paid the screws. Might be a few bucks in it for you, too.
Oh, get off it. Dutch treat, I reckon. Let's go.
They'll pay, every last one of them.
I don't know what you're so worried about. It worked, didn't it? Reynolds will still come out of it looking stupid.
That's fine, but we didn't get Jenkins. I don't like failure, Ferguson, and I don't like being made to look stupid by a bunch of Sheilas.
It's a disgrace. You know full well I organised that meeting for your own benefit and with considerable opposition. But if I hadn't, you'd have been screaming for your rights.
We appreciate that, Mrs. Reynolds. We certainly didn't want the incident to be a reflection on you.
It can hardly be seen as anything else.
We couldn't let him get away with what he tried to do to Lisa.
That is not your responsibility, Maxwell, and you know it.
Well, you can bet your socks he won't try it again.
No matter how justified you feel, you will not take action into your own hands. You have a complaint about inmates or staff, you bring it to me.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds. We just wanted to teach Wilson and the rest of them some respect.
You might try earning some respect for yourselves. Until you do, there will be no more reforms. Thank you. That'll be all.
I never seen a man with his pants on before.
Especially with that tat where it was.
Yeah. Hey, Kath, you know how
not
you had...
Not bad, Maxwell. You pulled it off.
You mean you had some doubts?
Good laugh, Avery. Even if Maxwell did get credit for it.
Yeah, right.
At least all those scrubbers will know why we call you a stud now.
I don't like you sneaking up on me, Slocum.
I'll settle down. Thought you'd be happy about all the free advertising. Well, they'll be lining up.
You know, come to think of it, there's a whole lot of things that I don't like about you. And come on here and I'll give you a rundown.
I only got a minute. Yeah, the boys reckon that...
What do the boys reckon, Billy?
I reckon it must be about time I went to the bog again, eh?
Look, there was nothing I could do, sir. I mean, smooth as silk until those scrags jumped me.
You were saying, Billy, about the boys?
I reckon he looked sort of cute, laid out like a cheesecake and all. I reckon they could have gone for him themselves.
You hear that, Stud? The boys reckon you look pretty cute, like a piece of cheesecake. Now, if you're a man, I reckon that'd make you pretty mad. You know, I've always thought you were a man's man, Stud. I didn't think you'd let a bunch of Sheilas make a fool of you. But don't worry. You'll get a chance. You do want that chance, don't you, Stud?
Five years, eh? You never learn, do you?
I thought pleading guilty and being honest with them might help. So you'll be 8 years old when I get out of here.
Yeah, you should have thought of that before. Come on, showers. Did the Hoskins turn up?
Yeah, they were wonderful.
All right, in you go. 5 minutes, Wilkinson.
Wilkinson?
That's the name she uses.
Sticks pretty close to Connors, doesn't she?
They're as thick as thieves. Why?
I want her in solitary tonight.
I don't know what you've got in mind, Craven, but I don't want her hurt.
Who said anything about hurting her? Breaking Connors won't be easy unless she knows we can put pressure on her friends.
You just remember what I said.
And you remember you don't stand a snowball's chance in hell of making governor if there's any sort of cloud over me at the department.
Don't push me, Craven.
bloody China. Give it a rest, will
you? What are you on about? You sound like a broken record.
Benny, for donkey's years, you haven't even sorted out your communications.
We've got our own ways of communicating.
Yeah, how's that?
Blackmore, you can't squeak without screws putting a fist down your throat. Once Spike gets it figured, she can send messages anywhere, anytime.
Oh, just like telecom.
Cheaper too.
Hey, do the blokes as well?
No worries for a price.
Hang on a minute, that little business is already sewn up.
Good, I like competition. Keeps things efficient.
Yeah, well, I don't. And your little efficiency level's about to drop by half.
Oh, look, back off, Simpson.
Oh, she's what, gonna let the rest of me business get ripped off?
No way. What do you reckon, Brumby? Doesn't look like much of a fighter, does she?
Nah.
Balance is all wrong.
Come on, girls. Come on, Scott. Come on, come on.
All right, Simpson.
Rich.
Come in with me. You okay?
Of course I'm bloody all right. I started it, not her.
Is that right, Simpson?
Oh, we were just, you taking me the governor's office or am I taking myself? Sort of works that way in Blackmore.
You ever pull a stunt like that again on me, Jackson?
Calm down. When I came in, she was attacking you.
You didn't even stop to see what was going on.
Oh, I see. So you think I'm playing favourites?
I don't care what you were doing, but you better get your act together or I'll have you.
I'm only trying to help you settle in, Margaret.
Forget it. Margaret's dead. You were a wimp at school and you're still a wimp. And the next time I catch you perving at me, I'll hit you with an harassment charge so fast it'll make your head spin. Listen, screw. You know what me mates would make of all that high school cheerleader crap and you mooning round me all the time? Dog meat.
I must admit, Mr. Craven, I thought you'd expect me to take some positive action against the women.
I'm not a hard man, Mrs. Reynolds. You can hardly punish them for a foolish act like that.
I'm sure they knew what they were doing.
I was talking about your foolish act, Mrs. Reynolds. Still, put it down to experience. The women don't respect you. There's not much you can do with them.
Come in.
Oh, sorry, Governor.
What is it, Mr. Jackson?
Marsh assaulted Simpson. She's already admitted responsibility, so I was wondering if you need to see her or shall
bring
I just
her in.
Take... Come on.
Do you have anything to say, Marsh? All right. Maybe some time in solitary will help
Just a minute. Outside, Marsh. Now.
Need I remind you who's in charge here?
Just buying you some time, Mrs. Reynolds. And saving you from an experience you'd never forget, boy. You better have some of my men take her up.
Would you mind explaining what this is all about?
Well, if you want Marsh in solitary, you're going to need muscle to get her there in an ambulance when she comes out.
Why?
I don't know. Claustrophobia, maybe. But she had no fingernails left after a last little visit to the pit. Does it every time. Oh, I wouldn't worry about it. Actually, I think she enjoys the attention.
Bring her back in, Mr. Jackson. We'll find another punishment.
Yes, Governor.
I wish you'd stop throwing that thing. It's giving me the horrors.
I want to be sure I don't miss.
Do you really know what you're doing? I know that Bongo's dead and that awful man does need punishing, but killing him's not going to bring your Bongo
so
back.
So what? It's justice.
But you're going to get an extra 10 years in here. Believe me, I know how that feels now. 5 years seems like forever.
Yeah, I know they were pretty rough on you. Any extra time I get, it'll be worth it. You got a problem?
Nothing seeing you back in Blackmore won't fix.
You're forgetting something, aren't you?
Oh, they'll rebuild it. Then I'll make sure that there's a door with your name on it. You're on a charge, Wilkinson.
Pardon?
You heard me.
What for?
Destroying prison property.
Oh, come on, that's ridiculous.
Oh, I get it. You're dancing and Craven's pulling the strings.
Just shut your mouth, Connors.
Oh, what? I don't suppose you want me up there too, do you?
Stay out of it.
Well, you'll have to take me now instead.
You'll keep. Come on, Wilkinson.
Oh, so we need something a little more serious, do we?
Don't you be silly. No, I'll be all right. A few hours in solitary is not going to hurt me.
Come on.
You just make sure she's right, Ferguson!
Of course, you always do the right thing by us, Mr. Craven. I was just saying that at the start, wasn't I?
Yeah, something like that.
Yes, and I know you boys always do your best too. That's why I'm giving you this chance, Stud. I don't like to see people laughing at you, particularly a bunch of slags like them.
Oh, I appreciate it, sir. Well, how do we get up to solitary?
You don't have to worry about that. Just make sure you're awake when your cell's unlocked.
No worries, sir.
My men will get you up there, but get this straight. You have your fun, but no marks, no cuts, no bruises. If you can't resist the lady's charms, make sure you leave nothing to suggest that you've been within 100 miles of her.
So why should I do her any favours?
Matter for yourself, stud.
Laurelly be my baby tonight. Laurelly you win.
You know, I wouldn't bother. You got seconds.
I don't care. Just don't want to offend.
Suit yourself.
You don't mean nothing, but I thought you had guts in front of Jackson. Must have known you'd go for a row.
Losing shop privileges and copping a few extra cleaning duties. Big deal. I could do that standing on my head.
Yeah, well, he was working up a real soft spot for you. Comes in handy having a screw.
Who
outside.
Needs it? Blackmore, they try it on every new face. Girls end up worse than they started when a screw spots something fresh.
Yeah, well, like I said, I don't mean nothing. You want to stay fresh, you'll stay out of my business.
I wouldn't go on a spending spree if I were you.
Poor bloody Laurie, probably counting the bricks by now. You think she'll be okay?
The freak knows, I'm onto it.
Yeah. Oh, is that all she did?
Yep. The busted door's my creative touch. Didn't win the prize, though.
Oh, I'll give you a hand to clean it up. I guess Laurie could use some time to think things through. 5 years, hell. Just for trying to get her kid back. Hey, maybe the freak had her sent up there on purpose so she wouldn't get a bashing. Now she's got a soft spot for Laurie.
Maybe. Let's hope I get the bastard before he does hurt her.
Right.